Yep, guys gotta buy this. Now that's great. It's the one time you throw it away, right? That's ecological.
Why?
Well, that's why.
I talked about that in the video a while back, about whether we're running out of depth or not. If there is a shortage, I wouldn't know about it. Obviously, I don't need it, but my point is, you see all these little stupid containers. The guy's got to buy them by packages like this. That's ridiculous. But I know it's available by bulk, but you see so much of this garbage just laying around. That's terrible.
And then check my oil. I found this laying on the ground. Because, you know.
Oops. Hey, where'd that go? I stopped at this Love's, thought I might get Chester's chicken rather than a little thing of pretzels that I had. That salad's doing good, but it ain't lasting forever. And they had the chicken, but they're closed, so they're not selling me anything. Well, it's a good thing I was walking around and looking. All right, brother, take care. So we had it held down by these tow hooks, which didn't exactly tow very long. The bumps on here, this is Highway 69. Coming south out of Big Cab, and we're almost to Texas now. And yeah, that one welded on too good. Take a look at that. Nice, huh? I still want some down, meaning I still want to pull the truck down some. A bucket is about 13.6. That's after I had pulled it down with the suspension. So what we're gonna now do is change how we have this tied. Grab the leaf spring directly with that big hook, and that'll also give us downforce. Alright, so now what we're going to do, take the piece and the D-ring. We'll go ahead and put it inside the truck. Along with the canvas bucket cover. I don't want to blow out or get too tall and make a weigh station think I was over height. Take a look at the back here real quick. Everybody's still tight back here. Everybody's good to go. Hopefully we're done. All right, hopefully we're done with them beat-ass roads. Wasn't expecting that. But all right, we got it hooked up one way or the other. If the other one breaks off, well, then it'll match. up, you guys. FSC Trucking. Rolling down here a little south of Austin, close to the town of Buda, Texas. Dropping off this bucket truck that we've been hauling for a few days now. And after that, we're going to go and deliver the skid steer that's right behind that. Rather than try to get to this guy's, like, a landscaper's place, which has a small, compact driveway and a road, we're going to meet him over here at the Pilot Truck Stop. I believe this town is called Mustang Ridge. It's off the 130 Beltway that goes around Austin, the toll road. A little less traffic going this way. Hopefully the toll road won't eat me up too much.
Good to meet you, Steve.
A long way, huh?
A little bit. We had one little trouble with it.
Okay.
They welded these pull hooks on the front. They didn't do a very good job.
Oh.
I took this off.
Yeah,
I didn't want it to blow off because it's pretty it's about 13.6 just sitting right there. and then the wind would blow it up like a big old balloon. And there's the, you can see the welding was third grade at best. Oh, there's a piece of steel. I think that was laying up top. They just forgot it there. Okay. I can show you on the side. I think they put that down under the for snow.
Oh.
Under the that black tarp. Okay. That way it didn't balloon down.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah, they forgot it up there. Thank God I seen it. But I would have fallen off and made somebody's day terrible. Oh yeah, yeah, good. You can't pop the chains loose, so I'll fire it up, get the suspension aired up. That's going to San Antonio. Yeah. What's that? Yeah. Apparently I brought the cold weather with me.
Right, it was cold up there, huh?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, it was much cold. And the yard is about 3 minutes from here. Well, let me, I was gonna park the truck on the other side because I can drive it back and I can have somebody else too.
Oh, okay. Yeah, it'll be a couple of minutes. I gotta take the front end off the trailer and all that. Yeah, they cleaned her up pretty good. I washed the truck last night. I told them to give it a rinse.
Okay.
Oh, this thing was covered in salt, dude, from all the snow and crap. Oh. See how they rinsed it off? I asked them, just don't be shy with the water. Still very cold. There we go. It was like 35 degrees when we loaded it.
Okay.
When I left Wisconsin, it was like zero. And it never really warmed up until now, which this really isn't warm. Not for Texas standards, anyways.
Today is supposed to get like 69, and tomorrow it's going to be 70.
Yeah, I woke up, it was 30, dude. right, good, it did come up. I was making sure it automatically raised up. Run me right out your paperwork and let you on your way. Alrighty. See, did a sign anywhere on the bottom?
Yeah.
Each one.
Okay.
There you go. Anywhere down there.
Fine.
Yeah, it's fine. And that one's yours.
All right, well, thank you very much.
All right, thank you.
No problem.
All right, man, good luck with her.
Thank you.
Awesome.